I'm going to discuss about the surface tension. So if you consider a spherical ball, you consider these are the liquids, and if you consider a spherical ball that has a radius r, it floats on the liquid surface, this radius r, and here density of this spherical ball, that is rho, is then you get and rho l, density of the liquid. Then what you get? And here, obviously, the rho is greater than the rho. Density of this spherical ball is greater than the density of liquid. Then what you get? We get mg 4/3 pi r cube. That is rho s minus rho l. If you consider a component, if you consider a force F, that is acting tangentially, and then it has two components tangentially, and it has two components, like that is F1 and F2. Here the parallel components cancel each other, but the net upward force due to the perpendicular component, that is F perpendicular, that is perpendicular components, which balance the downward force, and this force is due to surface tension. Okay, and this force is due to surface tension. So here we also notice that the liquid drops are spherical in shape, So that's been seen from this theory. Now, if you consider that V is the volume of the liquid drop, then yeah, and the spherical, which is the radius r, then what you get? 4/3 pi r cube, this volume of the liquid drop, that is 4/3 pi r cube, that is equals to V. That, or we can also write that here, for r, what will be for r? 3 V by 4 pi, it is r cube, or can write from here that r is 3 V by 4 pi, that means is equal to 1 by 3. Okay? Now, the surface area for of the sphere. The surface area for the sphere. Okay? Surface area for the sphere, what we do is, if you consider as a sphere, that is a surface area, then what you get? That is 4 pi r square. Here r equals to n, that will be the 4 pi into, if you put this value of r, then we get 4, 3 pi by 4. I hold to the power 1/3. Here, if you consider as a cube, it is a cube of length. If you know that the length of cube is similar as every side, then edge length, that is a, then we get a, that is volume is a cube, and from here we get a equals to b to the power 1/3. And so here surface area of the cube, then we can also write that surface area of the cube, that is would be a cube, a new surface area, a cube, it is equals to 6a square. What will be the e? We put this value in a, it's e into b to the power 1/3, that is 2, it is 6 into b 2/3. Okay, we can write that we get this value for a cube, we get 6b to the power 2/3, and for a sphere we get 4 by 3 V by 4 pi to the power 2 by 3. So A, what will be the value of A sphere by A cube? Here A sphere means 4 pi 3 V by 4 pi to the power 2 by 3 by 6 V 2 by 3. Okay, then what you get? You get here that, and here 2 is a 4, and 2, 3 is a 6, that means it will be 2, 3 and pi, then after the position we get 4, 3 by 4 pi, 2/3, that is approximately 0.864, that is less than 1. Okay. So the conclusion will be, for a fixed volume, what do you get? Surface area for the sphere is less than B. Okay.